অন্য সময় কিন্তু ঠিক আছে, কিন্তু যেই হরিকথা হবে তবে জানি পূর্বজন্মে আছেই কত পাপ কর্মে, সে লাগি বিধাতা করে বা ওরে মন রুচি নহে কেন কৃষ্ণ নাম, আমাদের কৃষ্ণ নাম শোনার রুচি হচ্ছে না কেন, পূর্ব পূর্ব জন্মের কর্মের বিপাক আছে আমাদের, ওর জন্যে আমাদের এই মনের মধ্যে অনেক কিছু এসে কানের মধ্যে ঢুকছে মনের মধ্যে ঢুকছে, শুনতে দিচ্ছে না, জোর করে শুনতে হবে, তাহলে আমাদের পরম কল্যাণ হবে। আমরা প্রহ্লাদ মহারাজের চরিত্র কথা একটুখানি আলোচনা করছি, প্রহ্লাদ মহারাজ বলছেন কৌমার আচরণ প্রাক্য ধর্মান ভাগবত কি বলছে, যে এই ভাগবত ধর্ম ওই বৃত্তকালে হবে না, উচ্চারণ ঠিক হবে না, পরিক্রমা করা যাবে না, আর বৃত্তকাল পর্যন্ত আমি জীবিত থাকবো কে গ্যারান্টি দেবে বলুন তো দেখি, গ্যারান্টি আমাদের নেই, একজনের ছিল মাত্র পরীক্ষিত মহারাজের 7 দিন গ্যারান্টি, বলুন তো দেখি আমাদের 7 দিন কেন, 7 মিনিট আমরা বেঁচে থাকতে পারি কিনা, আমাদের কোনো গ্যারান্টি। এই জন্যে প্রহ্লাদ মহারাজ তার সহপাঠী বৃন্দকে সবাইকে বললেন কৌমার কাল থেকে ভগবত ধর্ম আলোচনা করা একান্ত প্রয়োজন, কারণ এই মনুষ্য জন্ম দুর্লভ জন্ম, বহু দুঃখের পরে আমরা এই মনুষ্য জন্ম লাভ করেছি, আর তা বাদে আর একটা সবচেয়ে আমাদের বিরাট একটা যেটা সহজে পাওয়া যায় না সেটা হচ্ছে দুর্লভের সাধুসঙ্গ, এটা আমরা পেয়েছি, এটা মনে করবেন না যে আমরা এখানে একটু কষ্ট সাধন করতে গেলে একটু কষ্ট হবে, হয়তো আপনাদের একটু কষ্ট হচ্ছে থাকার প্রসাদ পাওয়ার, কিন্তু বিরাট একটা লাভ আছে তো এর মধ্যে, বিরাট লাভের জন্য তো মানুষ সংসারে একটুখানি অনিত্য সুখ লাভ করার জন্য কত কষ্ট অনুভব করছে ওটা সব ভুলে যাচ্ছে, তাহলে আমরা একটা বিরাট জিনিস একটা লাভ করতে যাচ্ছি তার মধ্যে একটু কষ্ট অনুভব করতে হবে না, সবটাই সুখে সুখে হবে হতে পারে না, এই জন্য এটা আমাদের এই শ্রবণাঙ্গ যে ভক্তির অঙ্গ যাজন করছি এটা আমাদের সাধন একটা বিরাট সাধন, এই সাধনে কষ্ট হলেও আমাদের এটাকে মেনে নিতে হবে। সুতরাং প্রহ্লাদ মহারাজ বললেন যে আমাদের সব সময়ের জন্য ভগবানের কথা কীর্তন করতে হবে, তাহলে আমাদের এই মনুষ্য জীবন সফল হবে। আজ আমি এই পর্যন্ত বলে আমার বক্তব্য এখানে সমাপ্ত করছি, পঞ্চা
বাল্যকাল থেকে এই হরিভজন করা হয়েছে, বাল্যকাল সে ভজন আরম্ভ করো, ভজন করো কৃষ্ণ কি প্রাপ্তি কে লিয়ে উনকে প্রেম কে লিয়ে, তো কম মনুষ্য জন্ম সমাপ্ত হো যায়গা কোই নহীঁ জানে, ধোকরকে করুঙ্গা ইয়ে সব সম্ভব নহীঁ হো, ও তোমার উস সময় তো কমর ভি সিধি নহীঁ হোগি, ইসকো ইনহোনে বতলাযা। অব দূসরি বার হে প্রহ্লাদ মহারাজ জি হিরণ্যকশিপু কে সামনে আয়ে আর উসনে পুছা তুমনে আপনে গুরুজি কে ইহাঁ পাঠ মে সবসে আচ্ছি চিজ কোন ক্যা চিজ সমঝা হ্যায়, तब प्रहलाद महाराज जी ने क्या कहा, अभी मुनि महाराज जी वर्णन करें उसके बाद
गुरवे गौरचन्द्राय राधिकाय सदालय कृष्णाय कृष्णभक्ताय तद्वताय नमो नमः वंशकल्पतरुभ्यश्च कृपा सिन्धुभ्येव च पतितानां पावनेभ्यो वैष्णवेभ्यो नमो नमः. At first I offer my humble respectful obeisances unto the lotus feet of revered Gurudev, Om Vishtupad Paramahansa Sri Brother Sajjana Sri Srimad Bhaktivedanta Narayana Goswami Maharaj and Om Vishtupad Paramahansa Sri Srimad Gauravananda Swami Maharaj. And then I offer my respectful obeisances to all the sannyasis and Vaishnavas and Vaishnavis assembled here. So, I am not so qualified as Gurudev asked to speak on particular subject. I speak something what I remember. When Hiranyakashipu asked Prahlad, at first he told that already Dhanki Maharaj told this. Tar sadhu manne asura varja dehinam. Tat sadhu manya asura varjadahinam sada samud vigna dhiyat asad grahat hitvatma patam grahand kupang vanom gatojat harim asrayet. He explained already these things. He approached his father. Tat sadhu manya asura varjadahinam, O greatest of demons. Because Hiranyakashipu was becoming very happy if he hears that somebody addressing like this. So Prahlad addressing like that. But for the second time, when he was sent to the school of demons, Sandan Amarka, to disciples of Sukracharya, and after that, when he visited, and Hiranyakashipu took Prahlad to the lap and asked, "Oh my dear son, what you learned from your school?" And Prahlad Maharaj told, "Oh my dear father, Sravanam Kirtanam Vishnu Smaranam Pada Sevanam Archanam Bandanam Dasyam Sakhyam Atma Nivedanam Iti Punsar Pita Vishnu Bhakti Chetanavalakshana Kriyate Bhagavate Adhyatan Manyadhitam Uttamam." He told, "Oh my dear father, O Bhagavat Bhakti, the devotion, devotional service unto the lotus feet of Lord Hari is the highest type of occupational duty for a human being. And that is ninefold. Sravanam, hearing the glories of the names of Bhagavan. Kirtanam, glorifying, chanting the names, qualities, pastimes of Bhagavan. And remembering the glories, names and pastimes of Bhagavan. Pada Sevanam, serving the lotus feet of the Lord and offering so much worship in my heart. Archanam Bandanam, offering prayers. Dasyam, accept servitorship and accept the friendship of Bhagavan and offering oneself from the heart. This is the highest type of bhakti and this is the highest occupational duty for a human being, the duty of the human being." And then also he told, "Madirna Krishna Parato Satova Mithobi Padyeta Griha Pratanam Adanta Gobhi Visatam Tamisam Puna Puna Charvita Charvananam." He told, "Madirna Krishna Parata Satova, O those who are completely under control of their material senses, they are slave of their senses, O the Krishna Katha, the nectarian glories, nectarian names and Harikatha, it never enters in their ear. Madinna Krishna Paratasatava. Oh, their mind and hearts is never attracted to the lotus feet of Bhagavan. Even by their own endeavor, they never do. Even they get association. Even others, they direct them, oh, like those demonic persons. Even they have association. Even the devotees praise them. Oh, this is the goal of life, to serve Bhagavan. Chanting the name of Lord is the only happiness in the life. Oh, this never enters into their ear. Their mind and heart never become attracted by their own endeavor, not by others. Adanta govi visatam tamishna. Because they're under control of their mental senses. Their mind is completely attracted to the sense objects. Like in Bhagavad Gita, Krishna Arjuna is telling, Chanchala imanam Krishna pramathi balavat dhram tasyam nigraha mandane vayuriva sudhaskaram. If the mind is completely restless, it's very difficult to control the mind, like the wind. You cannot control. How to control? Nishansaya mahabhava mana durnigraha chalam abhyasanetu kuntaya vairagyanechu kriyate. By practicing, detaching oneself from the sense objects, I'm practicing devotional service. By continuously getting higher taste, oh, slowly, gradually one will develop taste under association of devotees. Otherwise, one will never be attracted towards this bhakti. So this is the teachings Prahlad gave. I'll speak something. Nade vidushaktha gatimi vishnu durasayaj vahiratthamanina andha jathande upaniyamana tevisa tantriyam urudam nibadha. Oh, nate vidushvartha gati me vishnu. Oh, those persons are completely under control of their senses, under control of demonic propensities. Oh, they don't know the goal of their life. What is the goal of life? Svartha gati. What is the real benefit of their life? They don't know. They don't understand. That the Vishnu, to serve Bhagavan, service of Bhagavan is the only goal of life. Nathe vidushvartha gati vishnu durasayaj vahiratth manina. They are always engaged in vahiratth, in external affairs, in so many other things which is not important in their life. Only enjoying, eating, sleeping, mating, defending and earning money and own other things. They are engaged. Andha jathandi upaniya mana tevisa tantra murudamni baddha. Oh, if we are blind, we are completely blinded by the ignorance, we have no vision to see. If we make our leader blind, oh, we all fall into a dark well. At least we should know that our leaders, we should accept a bona fide spiritual master. Tad tasmat guru prapadyeta jigyasum shreya uttamam sabde paresa nisnatam brahmani upasamasa. Oh, we should approach a bona fide spiritual master. Who is Guru? Gu means darkness. Who can bring us from darkness, well of darkness, to light? Who can show the path of light, give us the transcendental knowledge? And he is the real Guru. We should approach such a bona fide Guru in our life. Tasmat Guru Prabhati Sabdi Jigyansu Sre Uttamam. We should inquire from that Guru. What is the Shreya? What is the ultimate benefit? We should not inquire from material enjoyments, topics of material sense enjoyment, other temporary things. We should inquire what is the real benefit. Shreya, what is the real benefit in life? Uttamam, Udgatatamam, how to can come out from the darkness? How you can real serve Bhagavan in the life? How you can be really happy in this life? We should inquire from the Guru. And that Guru should be completely established in this stage of self-realization. Completely self-realized, not Brahmani Upasramasram. And that Guru should be completely free from all any material entanglements. So Prahlad Maharaj, so many transcendental teachings, I don't remember everything. What I remembered, I present. Both the one who is
श्रवणं कीर्तनं विष्णु स्मरणं विष्णु की बात सुनते ही वह क्रोध से लाल हो गया, अपनी गोदी से उठाकर फेंक दिया। कहां से सीखा तुमने, कौन सिखलाया? षंडामर तुम लोगों ने सिखलाया? षंडामर थर थर कांपते हुए आए, बोले कि हमने तो नहीं ऐसा कभी सिखलाया। कहां से सीख लिया प्रहलाद, तुमने कहां से सीखा? नो यू से कृष्ण मते ने कृष्ण
विदु स्वात कथम हि विष्णु दुरुसायर यो बिहरात मानिनस। सो प्रहलाद महाराज इंस्ट्रक्टेड नांति विदु स्वात कथम हि विष्णु। पीपल कैन नॉट अंडरस्टैंड दैट सर्विस टू विष्णु पीपल कैन नॉट अंडरस्टैंड that serving Vishnu is actually in their own self-interest. Just like when you look in a mirror, who feels satisfaction? Do you feel satisfaction or the mirror feels satisfaction? By looking in the mirror, you feel satisfaction. Therefore, by serving Bhagavan, automatically we will feel ecstasy. Some people ask, why we should serve Krishna? Is Krishna very selfish? What service can you do for someone who always possesses everything, who is Atmaram? And up to come. They were actually service to Bhagavan is for our own good fortune. For our own. What service can you do for someone who always possesses everything, who is Atmaram and up to come? They were actually service to Bhagavan is for our own good fortune, for our own benefit. Therefore, persons who cannot understand that service to Krishna is for their own benefit, Vairati Maninas, they always accept external things as very important. But Prahlad Maharaj indicates here, Nati Vidu Swaatakatami Vish Durasaya Bahiratamanimas. Those who cannot understand that service to Krishna is their own self-interest, Bahiratamanimas. They always take the external meaning of the scriptures. They cannot understand the internal meaning because the scriptures are themselves, this Vachan, the speech of the Supreme Lord. Without devotion to the Supreme Lord, how you can understand the scriptures? You only get some external meaning. There's one very good example I heard. One time Sri Ramanuja Acharya, he was with his like Sanskrit guru, Siddhartha Prakash. That time another disciple asked, "Oh Gurudev, this sutra, can you explain?" Then Yadav Prakash, he explained, "Oh, that is very easy. Kapyasam. The Supreme Lord, he has eyes which are red like the backside of a monkey, a copy." So when Sri Ramanujacharya heard that explanation, he began weeping and the tears fell on the back of Yadav Prakash. He said, "Gurudev, you are such a great soul. How you can explain the eyes of Sri Krishna are red like the backside of a monkey?" Then he said, "This is the explanation given by Shankaracharya. Can you give a better explanation?" So Sri Ramanujacharya explained, "Kapi, that which drinks the water. What is that? The sun. So by the rays of the sun, what happens? The lotus opens. Therefore, Supreme Lord Krishna has eyes which are reddish like the petals of a lotus. But because people have no, they are not devoted to the Lord, they cannot understand the real meaning of the scriptures. Oh my dear Father, you cannot understand anything. You cannot understand that service to Sri Vishnu is the ultimate goal of life. Why? Because you have not covered your head with the foot dust of a pure devotee who is free from all contamination. Therefore, people's minds cannot be inclined towards thinking of Krishna until they take shelter of the feet dust of a Mahabhagavat, of the spiritual master. You have not done any of these things, neither have Sandra and Amaka, my teachers. Therefore, how you will understand what is what?" Then Hiranyakashipu became very angry. "Oh, you think I don't know anything? You think only you know everything? I have also done so many austerities. I have pleased Lord Brahma. I know so many Ved Shastras." Hiranyakashipu was not an ordinary person. All riddhis, siddhis, everything was under his control. But because he was not a devotee of the Supreme Lord, he could not understand anything. Therefore, Prahlad Maharaj explained, the only way to get knowledge of the Supreme Lord is to surrender to his own agent in the form of Gurudev. Hiranyakashipu became completely berserk. He threw his son off his lap and he ordered the demons. Sometimes a disease enters in the hand, you have to take off the hand to save the body. In the same way, this rascal boy, he has appeared like a thorn tree in a forest of sandalwood. In other words, the demons are like a forest of sandalwood. In order to cut down the sandalwood tree, you need an axe. What is the axe? The axe is Vishnu, and the handle of the axe is the thorn tree, which is very hard. That is Prahlad. Therefore, he ordered his demons to kill him. Therefore, on the order of Hiranyakashipu, the demons came, they threw him in fire, they threw him under the feet of elephants. Second Krishna Paratho Satova Mito Abhipadyate Puna Punas Chavita Chavinanam. Because, Father, your senses are not controlled. Therefore, someone whose senses are not controlled, their mind, their inclination towards devotional service cannot be awoken by their own efforts, by the efforts of others, or by a combination of both. Sometimes we see that people who are not determined to follow devotional service, even the instructions of Gurudev cannot help them because they are determined not to follow. Gurudev says, even if your Gurudev is Nityananda, but you don't listen to what he says, what can Nityananda do for you? Therefore, Father, you are just like that. Puna Punas Chavita Chavananam. You are repeatedly chewed, that is which has already been chewed. Just like when someone chews chewing gum and all the juice is taken out, then they spit it out. Then someone else comes and picks it up and begins chewing it. You can imagine how much nectar is left. Therefore, material life is just like that. We see people, our mother and father, they become very old. They become so much infirm, so much disease. an end of their life, they've had so much suffering raising their children, at least I know from my parents. And what do they say? Oh, my dear son, please marry. Even though they've had so much suffering, they give that, try to give that suffering to their own children. They have a guru that gives a funny example, like a dog. Especially in India, we see dogs a little bit malnutrition, how do you say, not eating very nicely. Therefore, there was one dog, and he found an old bone. That bone had no nectar in it, it was completely dry. But that dog was chewing it, and that bone was making his gums bleed, and the dog was drinking his own blood, and the dog was thinking, very juicy bone. Then the other 50 dogs in the neighborhood, they saw that dog with a bone, we have no bone. Therefore, they began chasing him. And as they were chasing him, they were pounding him. The dog was crying as he was running. And the other 50 dogs, they were also chasing behind him. Then finally the dog, what did he do? He spat the bone, boom. Then the next dog, the hairless wonder, he took the bone, he began running. Then the 49 dogs began chasing behind him. Therefore Buddha said, this is Puna, Puna's Chavita, Chavananam. Chewing a chew. Even though we see our forefather, my parents, my grandparents, their parents, they have completely tasted material life, but they have not received any happiness at all. And finally, the end of their life, they spit, means they leave their body, and they give the same instructions to their children, which they have done. They have not been happy accumulating wealth, women, children, house and home. How will the children be happy if they also follow that thing? Therefore, Prahlad Maharaj gave some very strong instructions. Therefore, the most important thing, unless we take shelter of a pure devotee, then how pure devotion will ever come in our mind? Is that bhakti sam jatiya bhakti? In the Bhagavad it says, bhakti only comes from bhakti. Therefore, where do we find bhakti in this world? Bhakti enters, comes to this world through the disciplic succession. Ivam parampara praptami manmaja siva viyodudu sakarana mata yoga nasta parantapa. Krishna explains, O Arjuna, this science of devotional service, this feelings of love towards Krishna come through this disciplic succession or this srota path, the path of hearing from the pure Vaishnavas. These days many people think, I will just read the books and I will achieve perfection. But Srila Bhaktivedanta Vikramaraj said, by reading books you will get knowledge, but feelings for Krishna, love for Krishna, you will not get by reading books. Feelings of love for Krishna, a feeling I will dedicate everything to Krishna, that comes by association of someone who is engaged in Krishna's service. So, unless we take shelter completely, isn't it, at the feet of the spiritual master, then bhakti can, our minds cannot be directed towards Krishna. Therefore we have come on parikram, but we should think, have we completely given our minds and to the feet of the spiritual master? If our heart is filled with the feet of Gurudev, then how material desires can ever enter into our hearts? Because someone who has given their life and soul to Gurudev, Gurudev said, everyone who served their Gurudev even for 1 second, how that person can fall down. Therefore, if our hearts have a place for Gurudev, then automatically our hearts will have a place that everything Gurudev has. Gurudev will give everything in our hearts for those person who has a place at the feet of Gurudev. Shri Guru Charanarati, Aise Uttama Gati. Those persons who have rati or affection for Gurudev and the Vaishnavas, then that person reaches Uttam Gati, or the service of Srimati Radhika. Therefore, Father, you have not surrendered to any pure Guru. You have not, even so many of us, I am probably most definitely included in that. We take Diksha from Gurudev, we hang around the Sangha for many years, but we have not completely given ourselves to Gurudev. I remember a few years ago, there was one devotee, he said, Gurudev, I want to put you on this Pure Bhakti TV. I want the whole world to know you. And Gurudev said, don't worry about the whole world, I just want you to know me. First save yourself, then worry about saving others. Therefore, when Hiranyakashipu heard all these instructions, he went completely berserk. You are giving me instruction? He threw his son off his lap and ordered the demons, you should finish him. Therefore, they gave Prahlad poison. But Prahlad offered it to the Supreme Lord, it became like nectar, Charanamrita. And Prahlad took that, and there was no ill effect. They threw him under the feet of elephants. And when those elephants smelled Prahlad, and the breeze from Prahlad's body touched those elephants, they also became good friends of Prahlad. Even the snakes, Prahlad was thrown in a pit of poisonous snakes. But such is the influence of a pure Vaishnava, even the snakes became gentle in his lap. There were those persons who were opposed to Vaishnava, they're in an even worse condition than snakes. Because even snakes gave up their envy of Prahlad. So they tried to chop him with swords, boil him in oil, burn him in fire, but nothing happened to Prahlad. Hiranyakashipu became depressed. This child has unlimited potency. He will definitely be the cause of my death. Therefore, he instructed Sandranamaka, take him back to school, and you can instruct him on politics, the four types of politics. What is it? Dan, Danda, Sam, and Ved. Therefore, Prahlad Maharaj went back to the school. The teachers tried to instruct him, and Prahlad was an expert cheater. Gurudev says, how you can capture Krishna unless you cheat him? Krishna is the ultimate cheat. Therefore, the Vaishnava is even more crooked than Krishna. Therefore, Prahlad sat in school, went in one ear and out the other. Then one day the teachers went out and they asked Prahlad, now you're a good boy, Prahlad, a pucker demon. You can teach the boys, you can be the school monitor. So, all the boys began running, playing soccer, everything in the school. Prahlad, come on, let's play. And Prahlad said, no. He said, now, like we're hearing Pujapat Parivrajak Maharaj say, we should not waste time because we can perform bhajan in this young age. Then the boy said, oh Prahlad, we can do bhajan when our teeth fall out. When we're old age and we're finished with material enjoyment, then we're completely dried up, then we can do Hare Ram, Hare Krishna. So many people think like that. In old age, we'll do bhajan. But even we're young age and we can't do bhajan. How difficult, Panikram, like going to hell and back. In old age, you cannot even sit properly. So many diseases, mind is very restless. You cannot even chew your prasadam, you don't have any teeth. And how you do bhajan at that time? Therefore, Prahlad Maharaj instruct, dharma acharat pratyo. Then he gave many instructions which we heard already from the devotees. But Guru Susrusa Bhakta Sarva Labda Panenacha Sadanam Sangha Bhaktanam Iswara Aradanenacha. In the condensed essence, Prahlad Maharaj said, oh my boys, if you want to do bhajan of Krishna, you should approach the spiritual master Sabda Labda Panenacha. Tanumana Jivana Guru Padayapana. Your body, mind, and words you should offer completely to the feet of Gurudev and the Vaishnavas. What? Does Gurudev want our checks? Gurudev, here's my pin number, I give you my credit card. Is this what Guru has come for? Does Prahlad mean this? Sabda Labda Padenacha? Gurudev only wants our real estate and our wealth? This is not what Gurudev has come to this world to collect. What do we really own? The really thing that we possess is ourself. Therefore we may give everything to Bhagawan, but unless we give ourselves, then Guru and Krishna are not pleased. Like Bali Maharaj. Bali Maharaj gave, Vamandev stole the whole universe of Bali Maharaj. He said, oh Chita, you promised me 3 steps, but you only gave me 2. Then Bali Maharaj thought, yes, I gave everything to Vishnu, but he's still not satisfied. Why? I never gave myself to Vishnu. Then he said, oh Lord, you can keep your foot on my head. Then Vamandev was pleased. Therefore, the real thing that we possess is our independence. So to offer our independence to Gurudev, oh Gurudev, I will not act according to my own whimsical mind. From this day on, I will act only according to your instruction. Then the boy said, that's all, Prahlad, can you tell us what to do? Then Prahlad said, very easy, bhajan. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. And all the demons began doing kirtan.
What are you doing? You're contaminating all of these students with this Vaishnava philosophy. Stop it! Stop it! Don't listen
Pallad?
Where is it?
Be careful, boy.
Contaminating all of these students with this Vaishnav philosophy. Stop it! Stop it! Don't listen! Don't listen! Don't listen to the Vaishnavas. Wrong philosophy.
It's a totally wrong philosophy. You should eat, drink, be merry. Enjoy yourselves. You don't know when you'll die. You believe in life after death? Don't be a fool. Pallad, where is it? Be careful, boy.
You think you're so tough? My Prabhu is everywhere. You better be careful. Father, he is everywhere, except in your heart.
You rude boy. Except in my heart? Is that what you've learned? Show me, where is he?
Jato, 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 jato.
এবার ঠিক সকাল পাঁচটায় এই স্থান থেকে পরিক্রমায় ঋতুদেব রাধা কুণ্ডে সমুদ্রগড় চম্পঘট্ট গৌর গদাধর মন্দির গৌর গদাধরের স্থান, তারপরে আমরা বিদ্যানগর এবং কোবালা রাধা কুণ্ড অপরতট হয়ে মধ্যাহ্নে এই স্থানে ফিরে আসব। মাঝখানে এক জায়গায় জল খাওয়ার দেওয়া হবে, আর দুপুরে ফিরে এসে এইখানে প্রসাদ হবে। তো আগামীকাল আমরা সকলেই এই স্থান থেকে সকাল সকাল বেরোব। পালকির আগে কেউ যাবেন না, মঙ্গল আরতি একটু আরো পূর্বে হওয়া চাই, আজকে মঙ্গল আরতি একটু বিলম্ব হয়ে যায়, সেই জন্য 4:30 মঙ্গল আরতি আরম্ভ করবেন, আমরা 5টায় ঠিক বেরিয়ে যাব। আজকে আপনারা সকলে হাম লোক কল সুবহ ইয়াহাঁ সে 5 বজে নিকলকর ঋতুদেব রাধা কুণ্ড সমুদ্রগড় চম্পঘট্ট বিদ্যানগর তথা কোবালা রাধা কুণ্ড কে দূসরে কিনারে সে হো করকে হাম লোক শ্রী মন্দির মে ইয়াহাঁ আ জায়েঙ্গে, ওর মধ্যাহ্ন কাল মে ইয়াহাঁ পর মধ্যাহ্ন প্রসাদ গ্রহণ করেঙ্গে, রাস্তে মে জলপান দিয়া জায়েগা। Tomorrow morning, 5 o'clock, we are going to Parikram, Vidyanagar, Samudragar, Champaghatta, Vidyanagar and Radha Kunda. After that, come back return in lunch time here. And come back return and we'll take prasad of here. On the way, middle way, so we are giving breakfast here. So morning 5 o'clock, everyone should be ready, so we are going to Parikram, first morning 5 o'clock.
Koi bhi Thakur ji ke palki se aage nahi jayega. Anyone should not go before Mahaprabhu, follow Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Don't try to that Chaitanya Mahaprabhu follow you. So surely you should follow Chaitanya Mahaprabhu and then after that all parties. I have seen that thousands of pilgrims though they go before Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Bahut se log aache jara Chaitanya Mahaprabhu aage palki aage chale jaye. Eta vidhi sammat na তাহলে পরিক্রমা নষ্ট হয়ে যাবে, পরিক্রমা ফল পাবে না। চৈতন্য মহাপ্রভু গেলে তারপরে সন্ন্যাসী সব একত্র হয়ে সব লোক যাবে। আমি দেখি সন্ন্যাসী লোক বহু দেরি করে যায়, কোন সন্ন্যাসী থাকে না। নো ওয়েস্টার্ন ডিভোটি সন্ন্যাসী দেয়ার ইন ফ্রন্ট, আই ওয়ান্ট দ্যাট দে শুড বি ইন ফ্রন্ট টুমারো, আই ওয়ান্ট দ্যাট দে শুড কাম অ্যাট জাস্ট 5 and they should be Parikrama. They should not go rare. So, I want that all Tara Sakali Thakur er pichhane jaben ar tarpore kirtan korte korte jaben. Sakali meyeder kirtaner khub prashansa korche. All are praising the Kirtan Sankirtan party of lady. Very sweet and very attractive. I want that also
Brahmachari party
Sankirtan should be more powerful. Gaur Pramanande
Hare Hare Gaur Kalka Riksha Hare Krishna
Kalka Riksha Kota Kora Sipan Paribajaman Ghosana Korben Harinam Dikshar Jonno Apnara Subhal Sakha Brahmaje Naam Likhe Diben Je Log Harinam Dikshar Lena Chahte Hain Subhal Sakha Prabhu Ke Paas Naam Likha Denge Hare Krishna